The quality of the air we breathe is clearly important. Now, most of us worry more about outdoor air pollution, probably because this is the pollution you can see, and it's the kind of air pollution that makes headlines. But if truth be told, the quality of outdoor air is more often than not superior to that of indoor air. And we modern humans frequently spend 90% of our time indoors. So what's polluting the air indoors? Well, for starters, you breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide. If there's just one or two humans in a room, it's not a big deal. But if there are 25 humans in a relatively confined area, that carbon dioxide adds up. Then there's your personal care products. These may or may not be disguising the volatile organic compounds you're emitting with alternative volatile organic compounds. And you're not the only thing in the room emitting volatile organic compounds. Fido is doing it. So is the sofa, the carpet, your appliances, the paint on the walls. You get the picture. The air you're breathing inside is a chemical soup. So what can you do to improve the quality of the air you're breathing inside? Join us for this episode of Better Body Chemistry TV as we find out what air cleanup device every home and office needs for better air quality. Better Body Chemistry TV is brought to you by Dr. Sandy, a scientist turned gremlin buster, helping you battle sugar gremlins, heifer lumps, and other health horribles through better body chemistry. Remember, small things can make a big difference to your health. So let's start with indoor air quality 101. The obvious thing is to let in some fresh air every now and again, and to be mindful of the sources of off-gassing, choosing low VOC emitting materials, consumer products, and companions whenever possible. But sometimes this just isn't possible. So is there anything else? This was on the mind of researchers from Portugal. They were particularly concerned with air quality in local schools, since kids are more sensitive to air quality than adults. They headed for the field, looking for possible answers. On their list of pollutant extracting devices was a pot plant or six. Now, they decided to test out the effectiveness of plants in a working classroom in a school located in the city of Aveiro in Portugal. The school they chose was a pretty average public school, built in the 1960s and located on a busy road with a parking lot in front and surrounded by commercial and residential buildings. They set up their equipment to keep tabs on air quality, both inside and outside one of the classrooms. Now, the classroom that they chose was 52.5 meters squared and was used every day by 25 kids, one teacher, and zero plants. For the first 3 weeks of the study, it was just the kids and the air quality monitoring equipment, and there was lots of it. The team continuously monitored the temperature, the carbon dioxide levels, the volatile organic compound levels, carbonyls such as formaldehyde levels, as well as particulate matter. At the end of 3 weeks, six plants joined the kids in the classroom. To ensure that the plants had access to the circulating air, the team suspended them from the ceiling, so they were approximately 30 centimeters off the floor. The team opted to use six plants because the Associated Landscape Contractors of America recommends one plant per 9.29 meters squared. The plants chosen to go to school belonged to three different species. And, well, they learned their ABCs along with the kids. Hopefully they enjoyed the lessons. But the biggest lesson from this study was that indoor potted plants can and do clean up the air. In every air quality parameter tested, there was an improvement. Now, the drop in carbon dioxide is not unexpected and probably much appreciated by both brain cells and the teacher. Numerous studies suggest high carbon dioxide levels can lead to fuzzy thinking. Maybe what was a little unexpected is the drop in some of the other nasties associated with indoor air. That drop in the volatile organic compound levels amounts to a 73% decrease. Impressive! This study demonstrates common houseplants have the ability to remove many pollutants from the air. Plants are relatively cheap and accessible. They are low maintenance and, well, they look good. So, isn't it time you installed one or two of these air filters in the rooms you hang out with, so you create better body chemistry and better health? Interested in discovering more ways to create better body chemistry, or need a little help getting your body chemistry on track? Visit our website at www.betterbodychemistry.com, browse our library, or enroll in one of our courses or programs. The advice is simple to follow and based on real science, not hype. Know someone who is worried about air pollution. Share this video with them so that they can install a couple of cheap air filtering devices in their rooms. And if this is your first time here, be sure to subscribe to our channel so you catch future episodes of Better Body Chemistry TV. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Remember, small things can make a big difference to your health.